Why does it have a little butt clothing?
Oh my god.
Oh, I can't poop.
It is your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things. Oh, yeah. You doing stuff and things, Tiny? Are you sure? Oh, yeah? No, it's fine. I don't know what's going on. Anyway, hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. We're back hanging out today on the Ark Survival Evolved Pooping Evolved server, making a little bit of mammoth kibble. Why? Well, I was thinking about, well, actually, it's raptor kibble, but that's what we're going to use to tame a mammoth. No! We were just about to make our last kibbles. Why? Inventory? Do I have anything? No, of course not, because I have a super clean inventory. And there's nothing in this area, I'm sure, to burn. We've moved almost anything that was worth anything out of here. All right. Anyhoozle, I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. Been thinking about what we're going to be doing next. Still waiting for the update for, and I think as everybody is, for the biomes and stuff and things. And, you know, I was thinking we got to start maybe making some moves on that new base. We can definitely, you know, we scouted locations. We know what we're going to build. It's going to be awesome. But then I started thinking, all right, so if we're going to start getting stuff and things going over there, like, I want to do something pretty baller. Like, I want it to be really, really cool. So we're going to probably need a mammoth over there. So I figured let's go get a mammoth at the very least and maybe start gathering up some materials to do stuff and things over there with. So started taking a look in all the chests. And found 3 raptor eggs over here. I actually went over to the kibble camp, and we don't have any raptor stuff and things over there. So came back over here, did find 3 raptor eggs, and we're making raptor kibble right now so that we can do stuff and things. Let me go ahead and gamma down for you guys. So yeah, we're doing this. We're going to go out and take a look for our stuff and things. Other than that, oh wait, there's something else that did happen. Oh, I got to tell you guys, that's the map. I wanted to say, as I always love to do, thank you guys so much for all your support on the ARK stuff and things. It is very, very much appreciated. If you guys like the video, please don't forget to smash that like button for me. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more daily ARK stuff and things. We got our 3 mammoth kibble now. All right, put out fire. So we can just leave the rest of that stuff inside of there just for the laters. And how long is this going to last? We put it on here. 11 hours? Oh, wait, no. 11 days. Spoils in. Why is the timer stopped? Yes, the timer has stopped. There, it started up again. We got plenty of time on that stuff over there. But something else happened, or a couple other things, just to let you guys know. I have been gathering up tons of metal on hardware. So huge, huge, huge amounts. And, well, not huge amounts, but a lot. I've made the trip out to the little area where we keep all the metal 3 or 4 times. And one of the little tricks I've learned, something that I was kind of confused about the other day when we were playing, was now with the buildable saddles, the total weight of the dino, as you can see here, is 363, right? So if we go ahead and get off the dino, it should be 363 as well. So it doesn't matter that we're standing on it. But if I'm not mistaken, if we take this out of this inventory and then squirt that into the bird, you should see that we are now at, wait, 401? Oh, wait. No, wait, what? I'm so confused by this. How is it now at 401? This does not make any sense to me. All right, let me go ahead and test this out one more time. So we take that off of there. Now what's the total weight on the dino? 400. This does not make any sense. If we put this on here. 345. Okay, that's what I wanted to show you guys. Does it take the inventory of the player as well? That's so weird. So we got this. All right, we got 74 inside of here. Let's just check this one more time. So we've got 345 weight on the dino now. If we go ahead and pull this out of here, our weight goes up. Now, if we just hit F, there you can see the weight of this goes down. Now, if we mount the dino and then hit F, there it goes. So now it's taking into account our weight too. That was what was going on. That was why I was confused. So if you are doing one of these mobile bases, these mobile like foraging platforms or something like that, it is a good idea, and I have been bringing like some sort of something with you, like an RG in this case, to basically just carry weight, because the platform does not calculate the carry weight. No, I can't get over there. Does not calculate the carry weight of any of the dinos that are on the platform. Can I move now? All right, sweet. So we have overburdened a little bit. Oh, he's just under mobility. Let's go ahead and kick that up another notch. But you can see here's all the metal that I've processed so far from doing stuff and things over, I don't know, a couple of hours in the last couple of days. I just go out there, get a little bit of metal, come back. Wait, what? That's all you can carry, yo? Well, maybe we can just get rid of some berries then. These are heavy. Does that make a big, huge difference? No. Does that make a big, huge difference? One more. Bam! So that's all we can put onto mobility. We'll have to pump more weight on him. But so anyhoozle, kind of a neat little tip and trick for you guys if you're using these mobile forges. Because when they first did the saddles, the buildable saddles, it did not take into account the weight of items in the inventories of whatever, you know, anything that was on the rebuildable saddle, and now it does. So, yeah, that's the thing. It's something to be thinking about. So, another thing that happened is while I was doing all this stuff, I decided that I would level up Bloodwing. That's his name. I decided I would level up Bloodwing, and he died. Bloodwing is no more. Saddest music ever. But happy times are here. I went out and got another Bloodwing, and he's level 149. This guy was 100 when I tamed him, and he tamed out at 149. Now, what I'm going to do with him is I got him up to 1,000 health. I'm actually not going to level him up by killing dinos. I'm going to let him passively gain experience just by being in the world, and they'll do that. He'll just kind of level up on his own as we build stuff around him and do stuff and things. He'll get better. Where are we going to look for a mammoth? Okay, we'll head over this way. So I'm going to let him just level up. I'm not going to take him out for a little bit until he's got a little bit of HPs and a little bit more attack damage, because a level 40 Ankylo took him out. It was pretty low level fight, and at that time Bloodwing was 155, and I had pumped, like, you know, his melee damage, his health a little bit. Oh, what do we got over here? What are you all about, yo? Level 8? Why are you guys always so low level? Get out of here, man. So anyhoozle, that's the news, all the news there is to be had from the last day or so, from the stuff I did offline. So I'm going to now head over to that mountain over there where we have the forge that we built the elevator on. I'm going to look for a mammoth. It doesn't have to be baller, but, you know, we want to get a pretty high level one. And then I will BRB's, peeps. And we're back. We're actually over at the middle island. Oh, wait, the volcano. This is the volcano is where we're at. Let me see. I don't even know why I got gammas on right now. Oh, yeah, regular gammas. It's just super, super hot. Super hot. I don't know if you guys ever played that game. All right, so anyhoozle, can we land right here, yo? All right, we're going to land right here. I found our guy, if I can get off my bird. I heard they're going to fix this in one of the updates coming up, so that's going to be great. Because it's super frustrating to try to get off your bird when you can't get off of it. And we did it! All right, so over here is the mammoth. We are going to try to... Are you attacking something? You look like you're furious. Are you coming after me, yo? You want some? You want to bring it to the limb hoop area? All right, over here. Level 92. So it's not humongous. Like, it's not 100 plus. But it doesn't really need to be. And I like the colors of it. It was, like, blue and black already. So it's pretty cool. We might not even have to paint it up. So with this guy being 90 or so, I had just over 100 narco arrows. It's going to take a minute. But we got it trapped. Already cleared out some Carno. You see there's a Carno that's dead right there. There was another Carno that's dead right there. There's a mammoth that's dead right there. So we cleared out the area-ish. Now, this mammoth was being attacked by a Carno, and you can see that it's already kind of bloody. So I don't know, like, what its HPs were at or anything like that. We're going to have to just see what happens. Hopefully, it doesn't die. I'm going to guess that we probably won't kill it before we knock it out. So let's see what happens, peeps. And it's down! We got it! It actually didn't take that much narco arrows at all. That was only, like, 14? Like, really, really low amount. That was really easy. Surprisingly easy. I wonder if maybe a scorpion or something was attacking it? I don't know. Alright, and let's go ahead and grab off our kibble, some mayhole berries, a little bit of narcotics, and see, can we squirt over here? Are we even able to... Let's get it. We got it. Nailed it. All right. Three of those. One of these. One of those. So, and then actually what we'll do, just to make sure, I just had some other mayho berries. I like saying mayho berries. That's what Corral says. He calls them mayho berries. And it's just so much fun. Try it. Try it right now. Fine, you don't want to try it? No, fine, don't. So we're just going to sit here. And what do we gut it out as right now? It was 92. It'll probably be, I don't know, it'll probably tame out around 130, I'm betting. So one of the things I am interested in seeing, though, and I'll probably bring you back for it, is how much taming effectiveness we get, or how much taming the bar goes up for eating it, for feeding it the one kibble. So we're going to test that out, and then we'll be BRBs. Not very much. So it looks like, what do you guys think there? Maybe like 10%? About 10% is what we got for that one kibble. Now, the taming effectiveness, of course, is down to, what, 95.1%? And I think that the reason it went down is because maybe it was damaged. I don't know. And RG just... What? No! Stop it! Stupid! Dude, you better not be attacking my guy. I don't think he could hit it. And RG came by here just a second ago. You can see right over here. And I didn't think it attacked the mammoth, but by the looks of the taming effectiveness, it might have got one hit in. So we'll end up taming out, like I was saying, at about 130, something like that. And it will be great for like a starter mammoth. We don't need it to be maximum levels. And it will be able to get us all the stuff and things we need when we're building our base. So I'm going to hang around here for a couple of hours. And then I'll be our bees peeves once he's all tamed up.
Why does it have a little buck hoik?
Oh my god. don't want to look at it. Oh, I don't want to look at it. Oh, it tamed up. Oh, baby, we got it. William Shatner. William Shatner, even though it's a lady, William, is a thing. Now, when I was taming it, it got friggin' hit again by scorpions or whatever. So she only tamed out... Oh, I think I'm stuck in this hole now. She only tamed out at, what, 129? But whatever. It's a, over 100. It's going to be a good thing. So it'll work. It just was unfortunate. It got hit by scorpions. All sorts of stuff and things happened. So let's go ahead and put an unfollow on that guy. We'll just leave her right over here. I'm going to head back to the base, make a saddle for it. And then we will BRBs, peeps. All right, we're back. William... Here's your saddle, lady. All right, let's see if we can get you out of here. Can we even? Are we able? Oh, yeah. Ish. Are you stuck on the bird? All right, she's probably stuck on the bird. Let's get the stupid bird out of the way. I mean, the best bird ever. Sorry, gameplay. You're not stupid. I love you. Get on there. For realsies? Huh, looks like it's stuck or something. Maybe we can get up in there. No, no, oh, God. There, we got it. And we're out. All right, so we're just going to go ahead and bring her directly over to the new base location. So we got quite a ways to go there. We got to head in an easterly direction. I think what we're going to do is get on gameplay. We are going to get a follow going, like a so. And then we're going to head out, man. It's time to go. Let's go to the new base, William. And we're back up at future base location, Slipgator. And we have William Shatner here now. He's down over into this early direction right here. And, you know, one of the things I was thinking about this area we're going to be really careful about is Spinos. So we'll have to build some sort of wall or something like that, obviously, in the front yard over here. But I really don't have much of an idea about, like, what this place actually looks like back in behind here, because it's all covered with trees and such. So I was thinking what we might do is get gameplay up into this early area, because that is a safe spot. We will get off of him at some point. We did it! And then we'll head down here, and we'll grab William Shatner, and we'll start clearing out the area, kind of just building stuff and things. You know why? Because we've got to, mister! Get it?
Do stupid things, man. Do 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 do
Operational base beginnings, just something to get us started, peeps. And I feel like we're off to a pretty good start. I feel like we're doing some stuff and things over here so far. You can see we got a bunch of land cleared out. I got some thatch. What is that? Oh, it's a rock. I got some thatch foundations down just so that we can stop some of the spawning of the stuff and things in the immediate area. So you can see all in around here. And I just kind of wanted to clear it out to get an idea of what it's all going to look like. And so far, pretty cool. Like, I think if we take this rock out, actually, we could probably just do that right now. Let's go for rock from our rock. That's a big old rock. And then this big old rock. Is this a big old rock? No, that's a big old mountain rock. So, all right, let's go ahead and get up here and take a look now. Oh, yeah, so much better. Well, we have all this space over here for a thing. We've got a walkway down right from there. You can see, like, down and around there. Goes down to the beachy area stuff and things place. And then we got our top area up there. We got all this area back here. And then this right back here, I mean, that's going to go up to the mountain. It's a pretty, like, it's not super close, but, I mean, not too far away. And I'm sure there's some metal up there. Then we got our metal that's right over there on that top of that guy. Oh, you want some? You want to take it to the limit, Carno? You don't even know what you're messing with. This is William Shatner. Oh, man, I'm going to have to take my shirt off in a minute. I'm going to be William Shatner. Oh, this guy's kind of high level or something. Let's take it up. Come on, come on. You want some? He's got to be like 60, maybe. I don't know. Let's see. Take a guess. Write in the comment section. What level do you think this Carno is right now? Don't cheat. Don't cheat and wait till he's dead and then put it in there. I know you're doing it. Everyone's going to say 76 now. All right. A little bit of HPs. I got his health up to over 5,000 just because I felt like that was kind of a thing that we needed. Throw out some extra medjool berries, but it's perfectly fine. Don't worry about it. And then we have this area over in here. But we need a safe place. We need a safe haven. So I've started the foundation of a safe haven type place. I think we're actually going to pop this one off. Am I slow? No. Right here, like so. All right, so over here, what I've got built, just kind of four little storage thingy doodle. There's a couple fireplaces. I got a preserving bin, already made up some stuff and things in here. Spark powder, put some berries in there just for nowsies to have and a bunch of meat. We've got a little foundation over here with our mortar and pestle. We've got our bed. We've got our water. It's amazing. And the nice little view over here, and I kept this beautiful little tree. Because it is kind of a unique type tree. You don't see this tree very often, so we're going to try to keep that guy. And got our piping and all that. You can see it goes down to the water. This is pretty cool. So far and so good. Pretty cool. All right. So inside of here, I have built already the just regular dinosaur gateway and the door. We'll squirt those in there. Let's go ahead and get this bad boy. Now, are you going to snap, homie? Are you going to snap on there, big guy? I feel like he was snappy for a second there. Are you not snappy? Oh, there it is. There it is. Right there. There it is. Nailed it, Ace. It can't be stopped. We snapped it in this snappy spot, like I so, and like I so, we got that snap. All right, hot snap action. Let's take a half of these bad boys, like so, 8. Now, are you going to snap onto this thingy? Will you snap onto there? Oh yeah, you will. Get your snap on, yo. Right, like so. Is that your? Okay, yeah, we got it, we got it. All right, so then if we go over here, like this. Wait. Nailed it. Like this. These are really difficult to place. Nailed it. And then one more. Nailed it, Ace the Campus. All right, and I've already built a bunch of walls as well. That's right, ladies and gentle peeps. I've been planning ahead for you guys. Keep the momentum of the episode rolling. Let's take half our walls. Let's actually drop these. Can we carry all? Let's actually drop these. Yeah, we can carry them all. All right, cool. So, are you a backwards place? Nailed it. And then we'll take these. It's always best to kind of squirt like so. All right, there we go. Now, are you smart? No. We're going to have to turn all of them. And we're going to go up three like so. Nailed it, Ace. The can't be stopped. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, baby. Now, you know, something may be able to get over there just to be completely safe. We just take a foundation, squirt that guy out over here. Will you do like a at an angle there, buddy? Will you give me the angle? Or am I have to manually angle you? I feel like I can manually angle you. Yeah, that works out right there, like so. It's not bad at all. All right, so it's got a little bit of a gap, but it's no big deal. I just want stuff and things to not walk over in that area. So now we've got our door. It's looking amazing, except for that it's backwards. I thought, oh, I know why. I was like, wait, it should have placed the other way, but it placed this way because I do believe it was snapped to the foundation. I'm guessing. That's how he got it in there. So William Shatner now can get in and out, right? You can fit through there. Oh, no, we can't. Oh, my God. I completely forgot about that. You can't fit a woolly mammoth through one of these. We're going to need a behemoth gate right over here. We are going to need a behemoth gate. All right, so we can build one of those. I can't believe I derped that. Eh, whatever. It's no big deal. It's no big deal. We'll get it fixed up. Watch. You watch. Hold on, peeps. And we're back. And we got the stone behemoth gate. And actually, to be honest with you, it's really kind of cheaper to do it this way. Because the stone behemoth gate, by the way, is going to cover the entire area. Look at this. With one gateway. And also, it's like not that expensive, to be honest with you, either. It's 300 stone, 180 wood, and 120 thatch. And then the doorway is 250 stone, 150 wood, 100 thatch. But I wanted to do the stone wall, and I had that in my head because I wanted it to be like I don't know. I didn't want it to be like super advanced. I wanted it to look kind of like a beginning's base. But yeah, so whatever. This is a way better option. All right, so we're going to go like a soup. And then are you out? Are you out there, buddy? All right, let's go look down a little bit like this. And then can we zoom out anymore? No, that looks about right. Like right there, right there. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. That's like perfect, man. Oh, baby. Let's take a look at it. Dude, how did that edge on that side right there? Oh, pretty good. Pretty good. Yeah, there's like a little bit of space or whatever, but it is the beginnings. So I also made the doorway as well. Like a soap. Go ahead and squirt that right inside. Get squirted. Oh, yeah. And we had any risk of stuff and things coming up this side? Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. Maybe. I doubt it. For nowsies, this is probably pretty good. So now we can open the gate. We can get inside. Is it going to like cover up a bunch of stuff? Yeah, but you know what? It's just for starters. It's just so that now when we come over here, we have a spot to store stuff, to store our dinos, not to have to worry about stuff and things getting killed-ish. Hopefully nothing will get up there and get the woolly mammoth. I'm thinking maybe a T-Rex could get up the side here. I don't know. He'll probably be okay. And he's not like a perfect tame or anything like that, even if that's the case. So anyway, the forward optional operational base, you know, we could just put another behemoth gate on the side there. The forward operational base is pretty much complete. We got our storage, we got our bed, we got our mortar, pestle, and our fire, we got our water, and we got our preserving bin. All of our stuff and things that we need to get started on our base. And we got William Shatner. So amazing. Yeah, we're back. What is that? This is like a random tail. Is that a T-Rex? It is a level 8 T-Rex. I wonder what he's doing back there. Looks like he's doing something. He's doing, what's he doing, man? Anyhoozle. All right, so what I want to do real quick is I want to make a way to get up and down from this level, just in case we, for any reason, need to be up here or need, like, safety or... doesn't matter. I want to be able to get up and down from here. If we, like, land our bird up here and then we die, we need to be able to, like, climb. Go! Oh, my God, dude. I almost... That was so scary. That's so scary. Oh. All right. So we're going to go, like, one of these. And then let's take a look down here and just see... You know what? I don't think it's going to be long enough. So, all right. And so we'll go like this and then like this. All right. So now the danger zone part comes. You guys scared yet? All right. So let's go ahead and pop one of these bad boys down like so. Like, oh, we're going to have to climb. All right. Now like so. Let's go like this. Could you actually move stuff around in your backpack while climbing a ladder? I don't think you could. There we go. Oh, oh, oh! So scary. Can't see. Can we do one more or no? All right, it's obstructed, so we don't need to. All right, so there we've got a way to get up in our ghetto Ford observational base. We can come up here. Damn, you see that? I'm like a Spider-Man. Totally squirted right onto that ladder and climb up over into here and get all the way up to the top. We're going to need, I can't wait because we're going to use elevators in here and it's going to be so great. So cool to have like this multi-level thing. It's going to be so amazing. All right, so the next thing I kind of want to do is I think I'm going to move. Oh, man. I don't know. I don't know what we're going to do next. I want to start stockpiling some stuff. There's so much to be done. Like, with this base, guys, I kind of want to go... I got some really cool ideas for what I want to do, and it just means we have a lot of resource gathering. What I was thinking about is bringing hardware over just to have in the area, but really where... I think that I would have to squirt him, like, right here, and then maybe build another behemoth gate and all of that. Let me see how that would work. Maybe a couple more or something like that. Whoa, the trees are freaking... There's a huge storm! Oh, and now it's fine. But yeah, putting hardware right over in this area and then getting some more RGs so that we could come up into over here. And what actually I was wondering if I was to build a bridge over here and get an Anki up on top of this place and just set him here. So then I could come over with a bunch of RGs, harvest with the Anki, get all the metal... and then get all the RGs and then just have them come right down over in this area. Like, there's a lot of metal up there, guys. Like, there's a ton. So I think that would really work as a way to get, like, huge, huge amounts of metal over into this area. We can get a couple of different elevators going. It's going to be such a cool base when it's done. Yeah, and don't forget, you know, we're not leaving Poop City. That's not the plan. Just for nowsies, with the new biome stuff and things happening, we got to be a little bit careful about where we're building and what we're doing. So for now, that's going to be it for today, ladies and gentle peeps. If you guys liked the video, please don't forget to smash that like button for me. Feel free to share and favorite the videos you see fit. May the stuff and things be with you.